Let's discuss the RDCs of the chapter The Sound of Music, Part 1. First is, there is nowhere that they cannot go. Question, who is the speaker and who is being talked about? The speaker is Anne Richland of the Beethoven Fund for Deaf Children. And the deaf children are being talked about. You may also be asked, what does the word they refer to? Then answer should be, the word they refers to the deaf children. B part is, explain the statement. And the statement is, there is nowhere that they cannot go. Deaf children feel motivated. They get inspired by Evelyn Glennie's story. And they feel that if she can do, then they can also do. There is no place, there is nowhere, there is no such work which they cannot accomplish. This is the meaning. It is about the inspiration which people derive from Evelyn Glennie's story. And now we have the value points which we have already discussed. There is nowhere that they cannot go. And in A part, we are supposed to talk about Anne Richland and the word they refers to deaf children. And the second B part, Evelyn as an inspiration is to be talked about. People feel, deaf children or differently able feel, that if she can do, then they can also do. Now here is RDC number 2. Evelyn was not going to give up. Or we can also be asked, everything suddenly looked black. And the first question is, why did everything look black? In this, we are supposed to talk about when it was detected that she was hearing impaired as a result of cranial nerve damage. And we can also talk about that her parents were advised by the doctor that she should be fitted with hearing aids and should be sent to a separate school made specially for the deaf children. B part is, who came as a ray of hope in her life? Here, we are supposed to talk about Ron Forbes, who spotted her potential. And unlike other teachers, he encouraged her. And also suggested that she should not listen to music through her ears. Rather, she should sense music through different parts of her body. And here we can have a look at the value points for question number 1. First of all, as already discussed, we are supposed to talk about when her deafness was discovered. Secondly, we are supposed to talk about hearing aids and a separate school as suggested by the doctor. Thank you. I will be happy to clear your doubts.